Thank you, Aldabe. Good morning, dear colleagues. I'll be talking about Boston keratoprosthesis, the surgical technique, and few tips. I must acknowledge Radhika for guiding me during first Kepro operation, and Dr. Aldabe for constant online advice and encouragement.
You haven't paid me once.
Yeah. So, I think you should know that 6,000 Kepros implanted till October 2011. This was a data given in their website. And in US it is 4,200 and other countries 1,800. So why it is so popular? It is one-step surgery. Can mostly we do under LA with intravenous sedation. It is simpler and faster than other Kepro procedure and requires about 1 to 1.5 hours to complete it. And visual improvement is usually seen within couple of days. So already indication has been met. The device is a PMMA, an anterior plate and posterior plate with a diameter of 5 mm anterior plate with 3.4 mm octave, and the posterior plate 7 mm and 8.5 mm. In 7 mm there are 8 holes and 8.5 mm 16 holes. But Indian eyes are a little bit smaller. I use 7 mm recently. I used to get a 7 mm plate from the from there itself. And now all the Boston Kepro type 1 are non-threaded version. And donor cornea is actually sandwiched between the anterior and posterior plates. And graft size is usually 0.5 mm larger than the posterior plate. There are two types. One is aphakic type. It depends on the axial length of the eye. So if you give your data, you can exactly get the that type of keratoprosthesis. But pseudophakic type, they have a standard power. So I want to share the first experience. If you look at Jina's lecture and this one, and that it is fitting all the criteria of the best indication for Boston Kepro. Like this patient had several regrafting and also a patient of Ameth glaucoma valve. And her visual potential was good. So we have all the investigation done. USC is a good modality to assess the copying also, and UBM is required in some of the cases because we want to know the IOL position on cataract or what is the extent of peripheral anterior synechia. So this patient does not a candidate for repeat PK because already the done thrice failed graft and 360 degree corneal vascularization. So this was my first patient from hand movement to 624. She is still maintaining 636 vision. So this video I have borrowed from Aldabe. So this is the animation of, so you need to have a 9 to 9.5 mm graft, then you make a central 3 mm hole and you shape the donor button there. There are pushers. So push the donor button, then this is the back plate. This was a threaded version, that's why this mechanism was there. Now here you have to just push it little bit. Then this titanium ring is very important and you hear a distinct click if you fit it properly. Sometimes there may be some problem with if you are not perfectly vertical, a little bit tilting, there is a tendency to slip that titanium ring. So at the end of the surgery you just put a bandage contact lens. That is also fast part is available with the pack. So I am showing the assembly part. So you need to measure the, this is a thrice failed graft one night, and you have to measure it. Then you make a 9 or 9.5. I use 8-point backplate in this. So what I do, I make a center point on the front part of the cornea so that This part is very important. Sometimes you may be decentered little, and decentering is not good because passing the suture is difficult. So just make a central hole of 3 millimeter. The whole thing comes in a box like this, and there are stickers, adhesive. This adhesive sometimes causes problem. The two adhere, and sometimes it sticks with the optic for a long period of time, and patient do not get good vision because of irregular astigmatism. So let's put the front plate. Then you shift the donor button there. I used to put few drops of viscoelastic in between. I do not know whether it is necessary or not, but this 3-4 drops of viscoelastics, preferably the higher viscoelastic. Then this is the 16 hole back plate, 8.1. This was fairly good that you can see almost central. So at this, push it little bit. Then you have a titanium ring, and take the titanium. This placing of the titanium ring is very crucial. Once you slip it, that means if there is a gap, increase in gap between that area, it have problem. So you hear a distinct clip there. So after that, you shift it to a BSS and keep it safely. So that is this. This is the my first patient. Why I am showing you, it is not so difficult. So if you see the first patient, Radhika was there. It was the with AGV, so I am not deep during trephination. So mostly I was with the blade. And there are a lot of synechia was there. So synecholysis with the iris spatula is very important. So if you look at this side, there is the area of Ahmed Glahal. This valve is going, so I was little bit careful at this area. So try to clear the posterior synechia. So after that, the procedure is in our hand. So clearance of more synechia. And the next part is just like put in 16, 18, sometime in larger graft you need give more sutures, and at the end you put a bandage contact lens. In aphakic cases, sometimes the patient with lens, crystal clear lens, that time again it is better to do ECC because of the anterior segment. At least it is very difficult for me to do a open sky vitrectomy, so capsule has to be preserved posterior capsule. So this case the lens was clear, and many of the cases lenses are clear. It is very difficult to do cortical cleaning in this case because this multiple surgery, this scleral rigidity is not that good, that sometimes you see that whole thing is there is a vitreous, lot of vitreous afters. So whenever you try to give a nick, it extends immediately. Then you have to take the venous scissor to make it circular capsulotomy and try to clean the lens as much as possible. This was a very soft lens. So additional surgery sometimes required in Boston Capro. Sometimes you need to do anterior vitrectomy, preferably with triamcinolone acetonide assisted. And cleaning is very difficult because we need to keep the vitreous face intact and the posterior capsule intact. Otherwise, your operating time will be much more and the complication will be much more. So this is the management of aphakia. So after that you go like this. So you need to do ICC with anterior vitrectomy, tarsography in some of the cases, IL removal or exchange. So this is another interesting thing that we need to do with Boston Crepro is the Ameth glaucoma valve. Either you can do prior may not be possible, and patient do not like this two-stage prolonged surgery, and this is costlier surgery than conventional cataract surgeries. So I normally do simultaneous AGV. I have learned from my glaucoma colleague. So only thing important is that if you plan it properly, Dr. Aldave has sent me a video, then we have our own way, so I try to combine, which is less time consuming. At the same time, you can place the tube correctly. So actually glaucoma is a problem. I have lost two of my patients because of absolute glaucoma. Like Gina showed that case of Murren's ulcer, probably glaucoma is chance is very high in that patient, and it is very important. So some cases, if you anticipate that glaucoma is inevitable, in those cases I think it is better to do simultaneous surgery. It takes extra 45 minutes maybe. So that always better. Once you have implanted it properly, you keep the tube aside, then you go with the this was a pseudophakic type. So you go with your usual K-Pro. Then what I do, after giving few suture, now I want to place the tube in the anterior chamber. Because if you close fully, it will hit the optic. So there is a 23 gauge needle. You have to cut it at the right place. 23 gauge needle introduction, slightly in a bevel and dimple down in, and little bit of viscoelastic, and then you put this tube inside and see the tube just touching, approaching the pupillary area. So you can see the tube here. You see the tube is here. So when inflate the globe, the tube will be retreat little back. So then fixation of the tube, and after that, nowadays I am putting the anterior corneal lamella for this rather than sclera. So this is also giving good thing rather than using sclera, which is so steep. So if you fix the tube, then rest of the procedure is like that, and at the end you have to close the conjunctiva very securely. So you cannot do peritomy with Ameth glaucoma valve. This is again a problem with Ameth glaucoma valve. So you should have very good thing. So there are some problems like severe bleeding. I use adrenal esox sponge and drop by drop diluted adrenaline. Suturing sometimes is difficult. You need to have 9-0 line on. Vitreous upthrust is common, so I used to give injection mannitol 45 minutes to 1 hour before surgery. I had some problem. I want to share this. See the severe bleeding on table. You see that on the first day you cannot see anything. This is about after 7 days you can see the holes. So the blood usually cleared. And this is another patient I showed you. This patient, you can give very good cosmetic. This is the only eye, other eye is normal, I have done. And patient is using cosmetic kind of iris painted lenses, and she is doing well. Sometimes repeated graft, ECC done earlier, what happened, the somering ring dropped on the post of 2 weeks in the pupillary area. So I took the help of vitreoretinal surgeon, and so they have done the from pars plana approach, they have cleaned that thing, and this patient is also doing well. I had problem with OCP. OCP probably is very difficult indication, because in your series you have not seen a single patient with OCP. So OCP recurrence, stromal melting, I called urgently all the way, and immediately I go for Re-K-Pro. This patient is still doing well. So in my series 34, 4 of Oro K-Pro, and 8 of patient, 5 of the Boston one is vision less than 662, no PL, and 17 cases are better than 618 vision. And I had complication, like as I said, secondary glaucoma is one of the important complication. We had all kind of complication you can expect: VVD, vitreous hemorrhage, stromal melting, Lee surgery done in 3 cases, RPM. Then endophthalmitis I had 4 months after the surgery, RD with PVR, the patient with late presentation, 1 case. And I had infectious keratitis after 2 years of surgery. And this patient emergency therapy, patient is awaiting for Recapro. Severe vitreitis is also I have seen, but this patient went into thigh sickle ultimately. So technology, what Dr. Aldave is telling, technology transfer has done. This is one of the case I did Orocapro. This was in 2009. But this patient had, what I find problem with Orocapro is the slot to fit the titanium. That is not, still I am not happy. You can hear the click, but somehow you feel there is a gap. It is not fitting snugly what it should be. So this happened within 2 months. There was a melting started around this optics, and I need to recrop the same procedure. This is the recent development with back plate titanium plate to improve the biocompatibility retention. I have not any experience, but it will be soon available with the Boston Capro. So in summary, Boston Capro should be considered candidates with one failed graft with vascularization with coexisting and severely vascularized scarred cornea. The one of the key important point of success, I must say, that meaningful visual potential is one point. Second important point is commitment towards regular follow-up. I am now 2.5 years, maybe more, but some patients are not doing follow-up regularly and we are seeing many complications. Thank you very much for your patience.
Thank you.